Okay, so before we go to MRP explosion problem, let me briefly recap what we learned so far. So we learned that there are three major inputs for MRP system. As you know, MRP system is run by MRP computer program. So we need three major inputs to be entered into MRP computer program. The first major input is the data from the master production schedule. So we call MPS, or simply master schedule. So this is all about end item information. So how much end item need to be produced. The gross requirement for end item information usually come from customer direct order or forecast of demand from customers. Based on these two major sources, we can gather MPS information, so that data for end item should be entered into MRP system. Second major input is the data from the bill of material, BOM. This is about product structure tree, which describes each end item and its relationship with the components. So if there is any engineering design changes that goes into BOM, then BOM is very important information to MRP system. Third major input is the data from inventory record file. So inventory on hand or inventory related information should be included in the MRP system. So having said this, let's go to the MRP explosion. MRP explosion by definition is the process of calculating the exact requirements for each item managed by the system. Let me explain this based on this BOM example. Okay, here A is the independent demand item. We call end item and the product A. And these are all dependent demand item, B, C, D, all the way to H. As you know, the order for dependent demand item is dependent upon the order for independent demand item. So basically, these dependent demand items managed in the MRP system is driven by the production order for the independent demand end item. So end item orders are entered, the MRP system automatically evaluates the impact on the demand for all of the dependent demand items. For example, in this case, A is the end item, and once demand for A is entered, then the MRP system evaluates the impact. Say customer's demand for A is 200 units in particular week, then we have to really find out the impact, how much to order for BC and all the way to H. But here, system calculate the dependent demands by examining the end item product structure tree one level at a time. As you know, this is level 0, level 1, level 2. So we have to calculate one level at a time. Say, to release A, which is end item, we need to B, C, which is a component of A, should be ready. So this should be required. So A is the 200 units, so B equals 2 times 200 units is 400 units of B are required before produce A. 3, C equals 3A, so 3 times 200, so 600 units of C are required before produce end item A. So we actually order these 400 units of B, 600 units of C should be ordered in order to meet the demands for A. And then we have to go back to the level 2. In order to produce B, we have to really calculate how much D and E are required. D equals 1B, so 1 times 400, which is 400 unit of D, and E equals 4B, 4 times 400, 1600 of unit of E are required. So before producing B, 400 units of D and 1600 units of E are required. Meaning that in order to produce A, we have to produce 400 units of D, 1600 units of E should be ordered to meet the demand for B. Then 400 units of B should be produced. Then we can produce A. In the similar way, this C side, you know, in order to produce C, we have a F equals to 2C, 2 times 600, so 1200 units of F, and G equals to 5C, 5 times 600, 3,000 units of G, and H equals 4C, so 4 times 600, so 2400 units of H are required in order to produce C. Then we are able to produce C, then we are able to produce A. You see, in order to produce a simple product of A, just 200 units, there are a lot of components and parts need to be ordered in advance. Suppose this is just a million units, and then you have more than, you know, 100 parts and components are required. Then how complex it will be to calculate all the components and parts. That's why we call explosion. For complex items, a small order for a single end item could result in inventory calculation and plan order for 100 of component and parts. So one small order explode into very complex series of orders. That's why we call explosion. And this is the, you know, BOM structure, right? This is one of the major input to MRP system. And let's go to the next page. And say this is end item A. As I said, we need data from master production schedule, which include end item information. That's the gross requirement for end items. Here, suppose customer order, customer demands happen in week 2, week 4, and week 5. Week 2, 50 units are required. Week 4, 60 units. Week 5, 70 units. So in order to produce this amount in particular week, you know, we need to calculate, you know, related components and parts. And then inventory record file. So this is about inventory related information. So on-hand inventory, beginning inventory, and then lead time information, and safety stock information, and quantity to order information. These are all related to inventory transaction. So these three major inputs are required for calculating MRP explosion. Again, BOM, and then master production schedule information, which is end item gross requirement, and then inventory record file. Okay. Now in the next video clip, I will explain MRP explosion problems. Okay, thank you.